What is this? If Uldah sat on the coast, that's what this is. It looks like freaking Uldah too. Not perfectly circular, but close enough. Same looking building, same color palette. Maybe not the green, but still.
Jeez.
Why does the city look so good, but the dock looks like shit? Oh, gee, I wonder what's going to happen here. Let me think. I'll go through some doors. Can't go back through the doors, probably. Now there's a giant open courtyard here. Oh, I don't know. What is this?
These creatures. It's not to be to extend this far.
It would appear so.
What's going on here?
This is a really effective combination, though, here. Can you target the ones in the middle? That's where the camera's aiming, son of a bitch!
Too slow.
There's gonna end up being a lich, probably. No?
You've caused quite the commotion.
What?
But then I would expect no less from you, Muthos.
Hello.
You again. I don't believe we've been introduced. You were in my family's crypt. And now you're here. With an army of Akashic thralls.
Manners, Lord Rossfield? They are men, like you and me.
Doubt.
Albeit ones unburdened by the wills that drive our kind to madness. They are pure. They are divine.
What?
And they are all that remains in this once raucous city.
You'll pay for what you've done.
As you wish. I confess, I have been very much looking forward to this. Pardon me, this indulgence, Your Majesty. The vessel shall not be spoiled. I am the Lord of House Harvard, and you will yield.
I should have brought back Ramu.
Or not.
As long as you don't hold back.
Okay, we're gonna have to learn his abilities here. What is this?
Nice try.
What is this thing he's put on me? Okay, it's a keep moving thing. Charges? Oh, wait. He always charges and then, like, I don't know, does some stuff. He always charges and then does a couple extra attacks. Oh, good, now I can't fucking see him. Not good, because I can't see. Don't exactly know where he's at in front of me, but I'm doing damage, so that's good enough. This is gonna take a while.
You will forgive me if my performance seems uninspired. It is just that I expected so much more from our chosen one.
Hey, who's the one that's losing?
Perhaps this will kindle your flame?
What now?
A gift from my liege lord's armory. Gungnir. Watch closely, Muthos.
Alright, so he's got a lance that can fucking shoot. Yes. Oh, I see. Okay, that was not what I was expecting. That's okay. Alright, so now we got... He's gonna attack three times. Okay. Nope, I'm out of sync here. That was a different form, different attack than before. Oh, for fuck's sake! God damn it! He did a complete... He's like, oh... Oh, now he does the horizontal one. See, he did the beam in the frickin' cutscene thing. I think he did it again! Fuck! He did the beam in the cutscene, and then I was like, oh, okay, so that's what I should be expecting. And then so he does something completely different, so I fuck it up. And then the next time he goes to do something, he does the beam again. I have no idea. I'm gonna have to watch closely to see what he does differently each time there. I don't even know what this is.
I wouldn't.
Okay, this is keep running. Holy fucking shit! What? Okay. Oh my lord, dude. What's he doing? Okay, that's... Okay, he goes for a swipe when he does the horizontal attack. That's a beam. That's the beam. See, I see it now. I see it. Okay. Shit. No! Oh, I dodged. I was trying to dodge the other things.
Give me more.
Stop enjoying this.
More.
Oh, he's doing this again. Get ready. Why did he do this whenever I use the tornado? Oh, fuck. Just dodge.
Slow.
Screw that guy. Oh, and I've got 6,000 now, so I can bring Judgment Bolt in. We got some sort of insignia. After taking up the mantle of Lord Commander of the Knights of the Royal Looter Army upon Sidolphus Telamon's untimely resignation, Sleipnir Harbord... Oh, that's his name. Okay. Served King Barnabas for the better part of a decade. Intriguingly, however, there is no records of a House Harbord ever existing in either Veldermark or on the southern continent, begging the question, whence exactly did he hail? Who the hell knows, dude?
The vessel is strong. My liege.
Clive!
As are you, I see.
Thanks for showing up now.
We are, yes.
I'm sorry, but we couldn't save them.
It was over before we arrived.
Well, you did what you could. I fear we were all too late. What's wrong?
Nothing. I hope.
What do you mean? No, you can't. Oh, jeez. Now what? What the hell? Holy fuck!
Found her.
Okay, I thought it crushed our... Oh,
leaving
great.
So soon, Mythos?
Can you just go fuck yourself, dude?
It's the king.
Indeed. You may kneel before Barnabas Tharm, Warden of Ash and King of Walud. Get back.
Wait, we're not doing this now, are we? What? We are? No.
My Lord Commander. Yet I see why my master covets you so. The power within you, Mythos. The potential. Stop calling me Mythos. But Mythos is everything. The cornerstone of all creation. The Lord's vessel. Your purpose.
Purpose? To surrender my mind and body to that thing. No, Your Majesty. My purpose is my own. I made a promise to my friends, to my people. And nothing is going to stand in my way.
You would allow this delusion of free will to bar your path to greatness? Truly, your volition is a cancer, one that must be excised.
Try it.
Joshua!
Torgal's carrying her sword. Now, I don't...
Power beyond reckoning. And they use it as a crutch. Such a waste.
No.
Be all right.
I don't care. What about Jill?
Phoenix can mend flesh, but the spirit must recover on its own. I'm afraid the rest is up to him.
There are perpetual tears coming out of my right eyeball.
Outfitting it must have been no small feat. But why go to such trouble?
That beauty's belly is filled with wonders the world ain't ready for. If the guilds caught wind of what we're up to, they'd all want a piece. All right.
And how is he? Do not blame yourself. He was barely breathing when you brought him here. We would have lost him if it were not for you.
No. Barnabas may have severed nigh every sinew in my brother's body. But he made certain the wounds were not fatal.
Nigh every sinew?
Allow me, your lordship. Don't know what I was thinking, putting you to the trouble like that.
'Tis no trouble carrying comestibles to my ailing nephew.
I know, but... you've already done so much for us. Pouring your gill into the hideway and now the ship. I don't want to take the piss.
You risked your life. And for what? Some gill you hardly know. Why'd you do it? You got mad or something?
No crying.
I wouldn't go that far.
You're awake, my boy.
Oh. All I want to do is help, and the world won't save itself. It was Sid, your father, who taught me that.
Sounds like him.
Don't you dare do that again.
What of the Royalists?
Fucked off, the lot of them. Along with the galleon. With the King on board, no doubt. Behind here, I wouldn't sail without him. Clive. Jill didn't come back.
No.
What do you mean?
She kept the King busy while the others dragged you out.
It's all right, Mid. Jill is fine.
The ether of her Eikon endures. As long as it does, we can be certain she is alive.
Oh, jeez, don't tease me.
We must pursue the Black Galleon. Jill will be with the King, I'm sure of it.
Well, good luck catching him, because my ship's going nowhere. It's the Mithril engine. She's got a kick like a wild chocobo and a mind to tear the hull in half.
But do you have an idea?
Well, of course I do. My dad'll have seen this coming a league off.
If I had his old writings...
If you had his old writings, you'd be sitting under a fuckload of rubble. The ones Otto didn't save anyway. I suppose you might still have a few pages in his stores.
We'll have to hope it's enough. Do what you can to ready the ship. I'll speak with Otto.
In your condition? You really are mad.
Perhaps. But the world really won't save itself.
Okay. Man, fuck that shit. Don't do that to me. Don't do the Jill thing and then be like, oh yeah, well, she's actually still alive. Yeah, don't play with my heart like that. A Song of Hope. And everywhere is new, pretty much.
Gav said that Otto might know something.
Hold on, I have to check this stuff quick.
Unto the mast and bellowed. All ahead.
Clive. Go on then.
Rune. Okay, we've got Rune now.
Come again. Or don't. I'm not much bothered either way.
Which song should we listen to?
All of them.
I don't have all of them. I'm missing like 99% of them. Oh, okay, that's that song. Yeah, that's a great one. One that pays homage to the old Final Fantasy battle themes with that bass line. Okay. I don't think I'm gonna read too much right now, but...
Let me help. I know my letters. Most of them, anyway.
Very well. The more eyes we have poring over these tomes, the sooner we'll find answers about these skies.
What have we learned?
I was wondering when next you'd visit. I don't believe you've read this particular chapter before.
A lot, apparently.
What subject shall we consider today?
Oh yeah, we got some stuff here. Persons of interest? What's new? At Drake's Fang. Lord Commander of the Kingdom of Elude's armies, Slipnir, was known to many as the Constant Knight by reason of his unchangingly icy demeanor and his unwavering loyalty to his liege, bested by Clive Rossfield after he and his master slaughtered the guildmasters and Republican ministers in the Canvarian Agora. Joshua Rossfield. Dominant of the Phoenix and younger brother of Clive, after surviving the disaster at Phoenix Gate, he devoted himself to uncovering the truth behind the emergence of the second Eikon of Fire. With the help of the Undying, he obtained a copy of the Journal of Moss the Chronicler, from whose pages he learned of the existence of Ultima. What? Where did any of this come from? The creature he was later to meet with and seal away inside himself in the sanctuary of Drake's Head. Now reunited with his brother, he and Clive fight as one to defeat Ultima and forge a new fate for mankind. What? Mr. Tomes is looking for a copy of Moss the Chronicler, the journal, anyways. So, I guess that's just a thing. Quentin, the inscrutable landlord of Lost Wings Tavern. Though he succeeded in taking his revenge against the Lord Chief Justice who put his family to the sword, he was left bereft after the greater number of his loyal comrades lost their lives in the process, and Lost Wing was swallowed by an ether flood. However, with the support of his surviving Lost Wing family, he swore to see the town rebuilt. Martha, landlady of Golden Stables, the tavern at the heart of Martha's Rest. The village became overcrowded after an ether flood in the Lazarus drove the Guardians of the Flame and the Bearers they had rescued from the Black Shield's raids to seek shelter there. To make space, she worked with Clive and Wade to resettle them in Eastpool, where she has been supporting them ever since. Whoops. Speaking of, Sir Wade, a loyal Shield of Rosaria and leader of the Guardians of the Flame, who fight to see the Duchy restored. After Clive assisted him and his fellow Guardians in driving the bandits from Eastpool, they and the Bearers they saved from the Black Shield's purges relocated to the village, where they prepare not only to rebuild it, but to rekindle the spirit of Rosaria. Okay, and lay of the land. What's new here? Guardians of the Flame. A clandestine group of ducal loyalists who lead the rebellion against the imperial occupation of Rosaria and Empress Annabella. Many of their number are drawn from those who survived the imperial attack on Phoenix Gate in the year 860, who know full well the Empire's involvement in the Duchy's fall. After their base in the Lazarus District was lost to an ether flood, they moved north, continuing their operations to revive the Duchy hand in hand with Martha. They finally resettled in Eastpool, where they now labor to revitalize the village hand-in-hand with the Bearers they and Martha freed. Eastpool, a hamlet located in the eastern part of the Imperial Province of Rosaria. It was deserted after the culling ordered by Empress Annabella, with bandits eventually moving in to occupy the ruins. The bandits were eventually driven from the ruins, and the hamlet claimed by a group of freed Bearers and Sir Wade's Guardians of the Flame, who had but recently lost Lazarus District of Port Isolde to an ether flood. The Lazarus District, an exclusive walled residential area situated just outside the eastern edge of Port Isolde. It was once the jewel in the city's crown and home to many of the nobles of the duchy. After the Empire moved its capital to the Crystalline Dominion, this once grand district was soon overrun with what appeared to many as thieves and cutthroats, but were in fact a band of ducal revolutionaries known as the Guardians of the Flame. Their occupation, however, came to an abrupt end at the hand of an ether flood. The Black Shields, an order of knights instituted by Empress Annabella in one of her first acts as Viceroyal of the Imperial Province of Rosaria. They were tasked with purging the impurities from the province, to which end they conducted cullings of both Bearers and those judged to be ducal loyalists. Some would later abandon their duties to enter the service of the former Lord Chief Justice of Sambrec, who charged them with keeping watch on his enemies in Lost Wing. Speaking of Lost Wing, at one time this small village in central Sambrec boasted a thriving winery, with the Gautland, I guess, something or other, produced there being prized by connoisseurs across the land. Alas, all the years of hard work were brought crashing down in an instant when the Black Shield, sent by Lord Chief Justice of Sambrec, turned Akashic, sowing death and destruction in their wake. However, before those few villagers who survived the assault could rebuild, an ether flood descended, forcing them to take refuge in the vineyards to the east. There, Alderman Quentin seeks to start a new village with his family. Men of the Rock, a private army under the command of Hugo Kupka. Originally employed to guard Drake's Fang, the bulk of the force was co-opted by Kupka when he seized control of the Mother Crystal and has served him and only him since. After Kupka's death, his forces scattered, largely returning to the countryside where now many engage in banditry. Kashlok, an old abandoned village built on the banks of Cirta's Thread in the Dalmekian Republic. Kashlok long served as a depot for crystals ferried up and down the river, but frequent attacks on these slow-moving transports by bandits prompted the Republic to establish new caravan trails for fleet-footed chocobo coursers. Essentially rendering the village obsolete. Soon after the final inhabitants departed, wild beasts moved in. However, there is an effort currently underway by Eloise and her Crimson Caravans to rebuild the town and provide it as a safe haven for displaced Bearers. Whoops. Okay. The Krojit Echoes, a bleak something or other wilderness stretching through central... You call this wilderness? I guess it is a wilderness. Central Dalmekia. Its northern half is a veritable warren of claustrophobic canyons and fallen detritus, lacking paved roads or outposts of any kind. In the south, however, the area finally opens up to that place, and beyond it is the reclusive community of Tabor. This and the lonely trade route leading to the free cities of Canver provide the region with at least some semblance of civilization. We're probably going to get an entry on Canver. Yeah. a federation of neighboring independent city-states located in the southeastern part of the continent of Storm. While originally part of Domekia, the cities achieved their independence in the year 857. Canver lacks an army of its own and relies instead on a city guard formed of mercenaries hired by its merchants and tradespeople. Unfortunately, the city guard, and indeed the city itself, were decimated in an attack by Akashic Waluter troops in 878. Having lost its political leaders and the bulk of its citizenry, the free cities ceased at that point to be a nation in any meaningful sense. So much in this world is fallen apart. The Empire has fallen apart, Rosaria fell apart, the Iron Kingdom fell apart, the free cities of Canver have fallen apart, Dalmechia has fallen apart, or whatever the capital city is, Rondala or whatever I think it's called, has fallen apart. The Ironworks, of course, because it's the Ironworks, it's Cid, it's Mid, it's where they're making the ship, it's called the Ironworks, you know, just like in from Final Fantasy XIV. A fully functioning shipyard nestled within the hollow of a sea grotto on the outskirts of Canver, the high cliffs and violent tides which surround it effectively concealing the interior from prying eyes. It is here that Mid, along with other allies from the hideaway, strives to, in secret, to finish work on the Enterprise, a revolutionary high-speed sea vessel. Okay, and then we have Mysteries of the Realm. What do we have here that we've learned? Ancient Mural. A religious image found across Velestia, not only in the apothecary under Phoenix Gate and in the Comrake near the Heart of Drake's Breath, but upon a tapestry in Tabor II. It depicts the icons arranged in adoration of a central figure believed to be Ultima, the god that rules above them all. Echoes. Strange clockwork constructs often encountered in fallen ruins. The question of whether or not they are truly alive is open to debate, as they do not appear to require water, nor do they feed on the flesh of their victims as beasts do, seemingly existing solely to protect their habitat from intruders. Though it is widely assumed that they are vestiges of the fallen civilization, some of the structures they preside over, such as the apothecary and the sanctuaries at the heart of the Mother Crystals, seem to predate even that bygone age. In the aftermath... Oh! So it's kind of like... It's kind of like the Protheans and the Reapers. It's like how the Protheans disappeared 40, 50,000 years ago or whatever. What smells like fucking shit? What the hell? And then it turned out like that the technology that people thought were Protheans was actually technology that was even older than that based on a certain other race. In the aftermath of the Primogenesis... Beneath the blackened skies that followed, they emerged from the ruins at last, and can now be seen wandering the entirety of Velestia. So that's why we see them out and about in places
you are always welcome
that we were previously gone through.
I know my letters.
So, I saw that Blackthorn had something new for us. Maybe the ability to craft the rune sword?
If it's knowledge you seek, we've tomes aplenty to guide you in your search.
Those tomes wouldn't happen to have letters in them, would they?
Trouble with your gear, or what do you want?
What do you want? Oh, I can't. Runeblade, and it is better than what I've got. Long before the Velestian alphabet became commonplace, early tribes across the Twins used a form of lettering now known collectively as runes. While most scholars agree that these runes were merely a crude representation of sophisticated pre-fall writing, some religious sects believe that the symbols hold power that is unlockable only when used in a specific order, much like those inscribed on the blade of this sword. I will gladly make
this. No scratches, right?
And can I reinforce it? You're goddamn right I can. Make it even more powerful.
I should do ya.
Nice. And we do have... Oh, wait. Okay, rune belt's not good, or not better than what I have, but this is rune crescents. These arm guards are not only thought to be enhanced by the myriad tiny runes engraved about the white gold ribbing, but also by the crescent shape, which in itself serves as protective ward of conversation or conservation.
It'll last you a good while.
I will take that, thank you, and I can upgrade it.
Yeah, that should do you.
Okay.
That it. Fine.
Oh, this sword looks weird as hell. It's got like a forked tongue on the tip. It's kind of interesting. Hello, Goots. What do you have to say?
Is there all you need? There's no one like our Nan. Your lad's worth double that. And I've never looked back.
So he was old enough to be aware of what was going on. Which is kind of fucked up. Well, as if it... Not to imply it's fucked up. Not fucked up.
Who cares less for us than the irony hammers?
Blackthorn can seem a little dark at times, yes. But under all that soot is a heart of gold.
Okay, we've got... Oh, a new note up here as well. There you are.
Marquis, I heard about Eastpool. That some of my fellow guardians are to build a new home there. Both for themselves and for Madame Martha's bearers. Is it true?
It's true. The village is to be rebuilt.
I have many fond memories of Eastpool. When I was a child, we would visit my aunt and uncle often. They would lavish attention upon me as if I were the son they never had. I went to see Aunt Hannah after my uncle passed away, but... not nearly as often as I should have.
Oscar, I'd like you to assist Sir Wade in the rebuilding efforts.
But my lord, my training is not yet complete. I couldn't possibly.
I warned you I might not be the easiest of masters, but I'm not as hard-hearted as that. Go. Be with your aunt. Rebuild her home. Is what she would have wanted.
Yes, my lord.
Yes, my lord.
My lord. I will not forget this kindness, my lord. I shall go to Eastpool. But as soon as the rebuilding work is complete, I promise to return.
On our own terms. I regret that both you and the lump had to get all tangled up in the wicked weave of my sordid past, but thanks to your meddling, I was finally able to put to rest matters that were left too long to fester. And with that finally done, might be I can sit back and enjoy this world of yours you're so keen on creating. One don't need a pair of eyes to see the good you've done, Karen. Duty. My lord Marquess, in your absence shall I watch over my new charges, affording them every protection I am able. I only ask that you do the same for his grace, Yote. Starting over. Clive, I cannot begin to thank you for all you have done for Lost Wing. So, in lieu, I guess, of any awkward... whatever the fuck that word is, dude. I shall be sending several barrels of next season's vintage. I can only hope they finally turn you off that foamy swill you and yours so covet. Emblem of the Hanged Man will rise again, but likely under a different name. Okay. So we're beating the game. So now we need to head down. Oh no, I see new hunts. Uh-oh.
If it's knowledge you seek, we've tomes of plenty.
Ow, my face. There's the rune blade. Damn, I remember when we got some of these swords way back at the start of the game. And I thought they looked so freaking cool, and then we didn't get to really use them for very long. Oh, there's Yote.
Lord Marquess, you seem unwell.
It's Jill.
I know His Grace has asked that I remain here with your people. But if you were to require my services, I could leave for the Free Cities at once.
There's nothing left of the Free Cities, I'm afraid. I wonder if her dialogue is from before.
Goodness, you're as pale as a poltergeist. Why don't you sit down and have a nice bowl of Molly's brown? Cole said it was an army of Akashic. What will happen to Mid and the others?
They'll be fine as long as Sid is... Oh.
How are we supposed to do our duty when the hills are crawling with a Kashyyyk and the valleys are full of ether?
How indeed? My men and I lost an entire day avoiding a flood that wasn't there a fortnight ago.
Will you be heading back to Canberra soon? You let us know if you need an escort.
Oh, right. We would be going back to Canberra, wouldn't we? Because that's where the ship is, so regardless. Okay.
What did you find down there?
Oh no, it's probably because your little arms are too small. Okay, we have Dread Comet. The hunters of Tabor speak of a wild chocobo that haunts not only the nearby Badlands, but also their dreams, for it exhibits a ferocity rarely seen in the species, and it has ripped more than a dozen of their comrades from gizzard to groin and feasted on their flesh. Good lord. The bird is far past taming. It must needs be put down. Alright, where's my piece of paper? And my pen. So, the sickle in Delmechia. Okay. And then we got another... Oh, this one doesn't have an image, but it's not an S-rank thing. The greater part of those black shields who spied on Lostwing were taken by the Aether Flood. However, we have received reports that one yet survives, a zealot of their evil cause who persists in delivering any bearer who strays too close to his hiding spot to a gruesome death. Alas, he has heretofore proved more than a match for the Cursebreakers sent to slay him in Lostwing. Sandbreck. Okay, those don't seem too bad. I'm kind of curious to see about this chocobo. Okay, let's see, does Horny Girl have anything new to say? Actually, let me check the infirmary.
Boils if Tarya ain't around, eh?
Oh, where is Tarya? Oh god, she's not around because she doesn't want to see to your boils.
Master Cid, have you seen His Highness the Prince? We were to dine together. Or so I was going to.
He vanished?
Before he vanished, that is.
Hmm?
I suppose now I'll just have to ask the bard.
And she's sleeping with everyone, or wants to, anyways.
It says here...
Get your game on, girl.
...once turned, and a Kashyyyk is forever lost.
Your brand. You're going to have it removed, then.
What choice am I? It's the only way they'll take me into the Cursebreakers.
Okay, I saw Vivian has something new, too.
Will it be today? What is it that you wish to learn?
Oh my god, the character list has grown. And look, that girl is still on here. The medicine girl. Encounter with the Undying. Dark clouds gather. Okay, so we're here now. Encounter with the Undying. In Dalmechian village of Tabor, Clive meets with the Undying, a secret society sworn to serve the Phoenix, who have been aiding his brother and his researchers into Ultima since the day of the disaster at Phoenix Gate. So we've got the ancients worshipped him as a god. He's still asleep. Which is he first? A leader of men or a servant of God? We journey together. We're coming. A master. I have to save her. He'll be good father to his family. An unusual sort. I have to save him. Thank you for minding my brother. He's in no condition to travel. But I can't stop him. Protect the people of the hideaway as you did me. Pray continue with your investigations. No matter how Ultima covets you, he shall not have you. His power grows stronger with each passing day. Why does he serve Ultima? May you awaken soon. We have much to discuss. Cheerful sort. What is Ultima and why does he want you? An enemy not only of us, but of mankind. Yeah, but besieged, so nothing there. The Phoenix is our sun, and we but the shadows that quicken in his radiance. She has fulfilled her duty to his grace admirably, the reason for our very existence, the first shield of the Phoenix. Come to me, we ride. Bid Muthos welcome, my lord and savior. Your will be done. Yeah, okay. All shall be as his majesty wills it. Allow me to test you. Well, you tested me, that's for sure. Wealthy noble. Do you have anything? Nothing. Still unconscious. Fall of the Free Cities. The banner of the Free Cities falls to the merciless march of Elude's Akashic army. Unlike the other hordes of Akashic that have lately plagued the realm, this particular throng appears to obey the orders of King Barnabas and his servant Slibnir, to devastating effect for the people of Canver. I will save you. Purpose is my own, and nothing is going to stand in my way. He bested me, and he wasn't even primed. Another servant of Ultima? That was called, I don't know. Master could not... That was just... If I had to be picky about the whole... Our standoff with Barnabas, it would be... That was definitely cutscene story fluff. Like, Clive made himself look like an idiot during that fight. So I didn't really feel like Barnabas bested us because he's just that good or that much more powerful. It felt like Clive was just being a bit of a dingus. We just had an intense fight with his Lord Commander beforehand. It had all kinds of crazy shit going on. And then Clive's like, let me semi-prime and just charge the bastard and do, you know, walk right into his ranged attack. You know, let's just let it happen. And then, oops, I got knocked on my ass. You know, that's just storytelling, whatever. You know, you got to do it a little bit differently to gameplay, I understand. Another servant of Ultima? Well, he's dead now. Presumably, but he had blue sparkles coming off of him. Bringer of Chaos. What do you have to say? Your duty is fulfilled. I am but a mighty act of God, my Lord and Savior. All men must serve, whether willingly or not. She knows that resistance is futile, yet she fights. I cannot hope to match him. He was no match for Clive. I must protect them. No matter the cause of escape, I beg you. Look after Clive for me. Get to safety. I hope she's all right. You needn't hide your pain. She risked her life to save ours. He could have taken Clive's life, but he didn't, because he chose not to. He bested us, and then chose not to take the life of Clive. I sensed something strange about him. Yeah, I know. There was little blue sparkles coming off of him. His power grows stronger with each passing day. May you awaken soon. How are you liking your new home? I shall pray for your safe return. It is an honor to know you, Lord Marquess. She has a kind heart. Serves not only this, but some rather infernal purpose. Every day he tests the bars that hold him. Sid's daughter, she's still... Oh, no, okay. Let's get this ship sailing. I thought he'd be more shy and retiring. I owe him one. We'll save you. He cut Clive down like it were nothing. And what about you? Because you were also there. Shall overcome this. Stand ready to do anything that is asked of me. To be with you again is a dream. You need rest, my boy. What god would create such fiends as the Akashic? Bloodthirsty bastard, we shall free you from the Blackguard's clutches. And apparently it was he who led us from danger. That's Gav. I await your orders. Speaking of, what about Gav? I'll do everything I can to save her, and so will you. We won't let you down. Don't fancy my chances going one-on-one with him. Trying to get yourself killed. True friend of the cause, let me help get this thing ready to sail.
That brings Study us... it well, Clive.
Okay, there's a lot of things going on. So, trouble in Canver. To Tabor, Gav brings the shocking news that Canver is under attack from an army of Akashic. Clive, Jill, and Joshua make for the Free Cities, a road that will lead them through the village of Tabor, where Joshua's attendant awaits. And that's... Well, that is pretty much it right there. It's just shit's going down in Canver. And on our way to Tabor. Trouble in Canver. The imbalance of the ether that accompanied the turning of the skies results in ether floods breaking out across Velestia. Many towns and villages find themselves under attack from hordes of Akashic, not least the capital of the Free Cities of Canver, where a veritable army of mindless knights has stormed the city gates. Death and Agora. As an army of Akashic knights rampage through the streets of Canver, the city's guildmasters, together with the Dalmekian parliaments, who had come to the Free Cities in search of succor, barricade themselves inside the Agora, or Agora, I guess. They are visited there by King Barnabas of Walud and his loyal servant Slipnir, who put them all to the sword. And to Canver, in Tabor, Clive meets with Joshua's attendant Yote and his chronicler Cyril. Cyril, I guess? Both members of the Undying who are sworn to his service. After bidding them both farewell, Clive, Jill, and Joshua press on to Canver, but not Torgal, I guess. So now we've got the Royal Knights of Walud and the Canver City Guard, plus the ship just outside port, leading us to where we are now. The Banner of the Free Cities falls to the merciless Yeah, okay. That's the end of the Free Cities. Bested by Barnabas. In Canver, Clive goes to the Agora in search of survivors, but meets only Slipnir Harvard, Lord Commander of the Waluder armies, followed by his liege, King Barnabas, an encounter in which he is gravely wounded and Jill taken prisoner, leaving just the Royal Knights of Walud here, and we know that the ship set sail immediately. Okay, so that's that. Oh, I see. I didn't realize you can... There's like a whole list of shit here where you can see all the locations of places. That's interesting.
Thus ends today's lesson.
Okay, holy tits.
How are we supposed to do our duty?
Clive? But if you're here, where the hell is everyone else? Don't tell me. They're all right. But it's a long story. You lot don't do things by halves, do you? Well, at least everyone's still breathing. Now, as for these writings, I'm sorry to say, Clive, but if you had those, you'd be...
Sitting under a pile of rubble, I know.
But we were able to save a few bits and pieces from the ruins, most of which ended up being used to build this place. The more personal items would go to the next of kin. In the case of Sid's things, that would have been mid.
Then I'll check the workshop.
Oh, we'll just go through her personal belongings, I guess. Well, okay. Sid's personal belongings that are now hers.
I'll try not to think too much about what was lost the day Titan attacked. If only it was just Sid's life's work.
If Amber and the Lazarus are gone, then...
Then everyone in Port Isolde is in danger.
Do you think Lid's ship will ever sail?
You saw that work of devilry on the deck, didn't you? The second fall of man is nigh.
This looks like it's from Sid's old diary. But you'll already have read it. I'd better keep looking.
What if she didn't, though? How do you know?
I know this is your hideaway, but, you really shouldn't be in here. If Mid caught you rifling through her research, she'd have your head. Then mine, for letting you.
That leather loosener was only the first of the discoveries the Alembic's gonna help us make. Just you wait, Sid. Just you wait!
What do we have here? Sid's pipes. Something tells me Mid won't be needing these. I remember seeing this doll in Sid's cellar.
I think I remember that too.
I wonder if it was Mid's.
It's got a scarily low quality texture on it, though, for some reason.
Huh. What's this tucked inside it?
Midadol, I know you like your riddles, so I reckon you'll appreciate this one. Of all my inventions, this one's the best, and so when choosing its place of rest, I recalled your opus, daughter dearest. And now it sleeps there in the first. I'm going to have to work on that last rhyme. Good luck, Sid.
Sid's best invention. That sounds promising. So Sid hid something in Mid's first opus. What would that be? Perhaps Otto might know.
First opus. That would be her first, like, proper creation, I guess. Something that is of hers, her own creation. Her magnum opus.
Well, did you find anything? Possibly. You wouldn't happen to know what Mid's first opus was.
Opus? That girl's as tone deaf as a banshee. Unless you mean the orchestrion. She couldn't have been more than
Orchestrion, of course, it's got a different pronunciation. Together.
It surprised us all. Not least her dad. You should have seen how proud he was of the little scamp. What's that battered old box have to do with anything?
I think Sid may have hidden something inside it.
Wouldn't surprise me. Those two and their bloody treasure hunts. Half the things in the hideaway were hidden one time or another. The orchestrion's in the tub and crown, where it's always been.
Okay, well, I guess I can change the music while we're over there. We need some new music for the change in story events. Not that I really have much. Dude, why are the kids here?
I didn't break it. Well, I didn't break it.
What didn't you break?
Nothing. We didn't break nothing. We definitely didn't break the orchestrion.
What's wrong with it?
It's broken. Except when it isn't. See?
And you had nothing to do with this?
Nope. Nothing. We just wanted to listen to all the songs at once.
You dingus.
So we press all the buttons. Like this.
It'll do it again.
See?
All too well. All right, out of the way.
Can I actually? Well, I guess I can't use it right now. Playing Sid's theme? Or the original Hideaway theme?
Never heard this one before.
They started playing when I removed this. Whatever it is.
I can't tell what it is, actually. What is that?
Well, don't look at me. I can tell you it's important, though. Sid showed it to me once and said as much. Said it was the stuff dreams were made of. Let's just hope it's the stuff ships are made of as well.
Indeed. Let's see if we can make some dreams come true.
Yeah, it's gotta be like a Sid theme. Or some sort of Sid related motif. Okay. Like father, like daughter.
Just the two I was looking for.
Oh, what about the prince?
Who's a patient?
Actually, yes. The Crown Prince just left.
Dion left?
Unless you've another word for stood up and walked off. Yes, left.
He did have the decency to leave a message with Obelisk before commandeering one of his dinghies. Did we go after him?
No. We're not the prince's keepers. He's free to do as he sees fit.
I was hoping to talk to
the
dude.
I'd rather he did so in bed. His wounds are nowhere near healed. Much like yours, I suspect. Otto told me what happened in Canver. What is it with this realm's princes and their aversion to rest?
Ask me when I get back. Though I may be some time.
Then at least try to stay safe.
And if that fails, try to stay alive, eh? Every moment I waste here, the further the flagship sails. I have to get back.
Every moment I waste here, the further the flagship sails, and then the game gives me a new quest to do. Like, fuck's sake. Not just one, not just two, but three. Come on, man. Don't do that. Give me a new more quest, fine, but don't say like, oh man, we gotta get this going or the fucking world's gonna end. Holy shit. Oh, look, so there's some new quests, by the way.
Is there any more treasure in the Orchestrion? Only one way to find out.
I am going to bunt these kids off of this ship if they do that. Okay. What is new here? Nothing. I was lied to. Or it must be what's selected. Good bones, yeah. Alright, I'd say, yeah, let's go with this. Why not? Oh, wait, no, that was just me listening to it. I already said why I wouldn't do this, but fuck it. We need some epic music, you know? We're chasing after Odin himself.
Let me help. I know my letters.
Good morrow to you, my friend.
Now, why do you have
something
new?
I have a few new notes that might interest you.
Now what?
There is a rather fascinating excerpt I've been meaning to show you.
Magitek? What? What? Okay, hold on. We just got a frickload of stuff for some reason. Okay, well, that's going to have to be for next episode because we're up to 1 hour and 3 minutes. And then we've got... What have we got? Looks like we got a new reputation. We have a quest here. We have a quest here. We have quest way up here. Please, sir, can I have some more bowl? I wonder what this quest is going to be about. Is the herbalist or botanist or whoever that is going to be like, oh, you know what? I could really use some more bowl tentacle or something. You know, could you go kill me one? And let me guess. I'm going to just guess right now. It's that place in Rosaria, isn't it? It's that, like, water place where we fought some of those little crab things, those crayfish things, right when we came there for the first time. That's, like, this big, open, watery pit, but nothing's there. I bet that's where we fight it. Bet ya. Betting ya right now. Okay, and then what is this? Blacksmith Blues 3. Not again. Okay, and then what about this? Tears of Mercy. Oh, jeez, man. And here I was thinking, oh, we're not gonna get any side quests for a little while, but... Yeah, we only got three of them. Alright, let's go ahead and save. I was going to stop with the last episode, then I decided to do one more, and now I want to do another one. I'm going to have a food break. This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to stop this episode, have a food break, and then I'm going to decide if I want to play any more. I'm not tired yet or anything. I had the itch to play a little bit of Minecraft, so I was going to do that before getting tired. But, well, this game keeps snagging me by the nuts, so... Okay. By the way, we'll do that next time. Let's go ahead and save. Okay, and I will see you guys in the next episode of Let's Play Final Fantasy XVI.